I can't leave the house without putting makeup on. So I just feel so ugly, and I've got it down to quite a fine art now, but it's still very time consuming when I've got a lot of other stuff to do in the morning.
Come on then, let's put your shoes on. I try not to let it affect my children. Obviously I can't mask everything. I've had it for 12 years. The first lesions were on the side of my face. They then spread to the front. I'm very concerned about how fast my skin is changing. So that's no makeup whatsoever.
Oh, wow. And look at you. You look very confident. It's only when you're looking back at photographs of then and now.
Yeah.
Just how much
it's taken away from me. Yeah.
Yeah. She's a real fighter, but over the years, it's really affected her self-esteem.
They both crashed.
I just feel so powerless over it, really. It's like it's marching on its own feet and we can't stop it.
It feels like how you would imagine an acne spot feels, that's deep under the skin. Is this a newer one?
Yeah.
This one has got a substance to it, whereas these ones don't really have any substance to them anymore.
This one here, that's
it's pretty
beastie.
Turn your head towards me. Thank you. So this is the beastie, isn't
yeah.
it? Interestingly, the beastie you can't really feel, whereas these new ones you can feel if your eyes were closed, you know where they are, but not so much with the beastie. But the beastie is red.
Yeah.
And you can see those superficial vessels quite clearly. And this is the one that's been here then for the longest amount of time.
Yeah. It's still quite red, that one, I think.
They have this slight atrophic epidermis, and what I mean by that is a slight wrinkling just over the surface of them. And then on the cheeks here, where you can see this generalised background redness. I think looking at this, this is going to be a type of seborrheic dermatitis. And it's a type of a very inflammatory response to the yeast that lives on the skin. We don't know why some people react to it and some people don't. And it's usually down to your own immune response, your own host response to it. And sometimes things like hormones. You also have a rosacea. So if you look at the face of somebody who has rosacea, their face tends to be redder and they will have more blood vessels around their nose and scattered across their cheeks. But what we need to do is biopsies in the swabs and your blood tests just to confirm everything. Is that okay?
Okay. My main thing, really, is it going to be treatable?
I'll use the lasers to get rid of the bits of the red that are there. You'll have to take a tablet for a short amount of time, and then you'll have to put cream on morning and night, but that they will be away. They'll not be there.
It's amazing. Thank you so much.
Well, you can thank me in a couple of months. So Amy's come to see me with what she thought was one condition, but in actual fact, I think she has two diagnoses.
I want you to take a deep breath in. One, two, three.
Now, it's not unusual to get seborrheic dermatitis and rosacea presenting in the same person, but I think in Amy's particular case, other clinicians have found it quite difficult to make a diagnosis with her because the way that Amy's is presenting is really different to how I've actually seen it before.
And we're just gonna push down onto the skin. Did you feel anything?
No.
Both conditions are treated with a combination of topical therapies as well as oral therapies. And if the biopsy confirms my suspicions, then we'll be able to get started straight away.
Oh, hi, Amy.
Hi.
How did you get on?
I got on really well. Yeah, they're hoping that they'll be able to treat me.
Oh, I'm so pleased for you.
Oh, God.
I know. Oh, it's a long time.
This has been such an emotional day for me. I feel like I've actually got answers and it's going to be life-changing with this skin condition go. I'll be like a normal person because I really don't feel that at the moment. Very excited.
Yeah.
Can't wait to see her.
It's just great that things are moving along now.
Yeah, it is really good.
Yeah.
Hiya, Amy.
Hiya.
You want to come on down?
Yeah, sure.
Like these dungarees. Moddy's in her dungarees today as well. All right, Amy. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too.
So it's been about 9 months since you came to me because you really just didn't know what was going on with the skin.
That's right, yeah.
So you've been on a tablet and you've been using the creams I give you, and we've done 6 laser sessions. And how do you feel now?
I'm feeling better. I am getting more confident. I don't wear as much makeup. I don't wear any concealer at all. I just wear foundation and powder. And
that's good.
Yeah, I'd say 60% it's got better, but I just want to have the confidence to be able to go and do activities with my children. I just want to go swimming without people staring at me.
Do you mind if I have a look now?
Yeah.
Can we take the makeup off and have a look to see exactly where we are?
That's fine.
Okay, lie yourself back here and I'll just get the swabs to take the makeup off. Right, okay, right, sit yourself up. I think that normally we like to, you know, under-promise and over-deliver. And you just told me 60%, but this is like 90% better. I mean, what a glow of the light hitting off your skin. It's so beautiful. So you can see these areas that were very thick and red and standing out a lot is all clear. The ones that were big and angry on the forehead that were dotted kind of all the way around, they're all much better. I forbid you for putting on all of that foundation. Your skin looks amazing.
Okay.
Well, look at the glow off it.
I know.
It's remarkable.
So I'm so happy with it.
And we're going to throw that makeup in the bin?
Yep.
Yeah. It can be very difficult for somebody who has had a skin condition for such a long period of time, particularly one that's taken over quite a lot of their life, to recognise that when their skin has recovered and the treatment has worked, the brain takes a little bit of time to catch up. And that's exactly what's happened to Amy. When she does start to recognise this in herself, when she looks back in the mirror, then I think that's going to give her a whole new lease of life.
You're walking out of here without any makeup on.
No makeup.
I know, I can't believe it.
So I have a massive update. I've just come back from going swimming. I can't believe I've been swimming. It's the first time I've been swimming for about 10 years. I didn't feel worried or scared of people looking at me. I had so much confidence, and it's all down to Dr. Emma and her amazing team of helping me. And I also did the school run without any makeup on. That's the first time ever.